study finds older children could spread COVID-19 like adults. The study published in the Emerging Infectious Disease Journal by the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention highlighted the transmission risk among students. A total of 59,073 contacts of 5,706 COVID-19 index patients in South Korea were analyzed. Researchers examined the reports from these individuals from January 20 to March 27, 2020. Out of the 10,592 household contacts, 11.8% had COVID-19, while out of 48,481 non-household contacts, 1.9% had a novel disease. The author said that preventive measures and social distancing decreased the chance of transmission. According to the New York Times, the study offered insights into possible outbreaks in schools. Both children and teens could transmit SARS-CoV-2 to others just like adults. Children aged 10 years or younger could transmit COVID-19 much less than adults do. However, teens could spread it similar to adults too. Infectious diseases expert at the University of Minnesota, Michael Osterholm, said, "I fear that there has been this sense that kids just won't get infected or don't get infected in the same way as adults, and that therefore, they're almost like a bubbled population. But the transmission is inevitable and must be included in any plan of school reopening to prevent or reduce new COVID-19 clusters." The sense that kids are unlikely to get infected or to spread COVID-19 may be connected to previous studies from Asia and Europe. While pediatric cases of COVID-19 have been observed fewer than adult cases, the numbers still show that everyone can be infected by SARS-CoV-2. Also, the fewer pediatric reports of COVID-19 may be affected by the presence of symptoms. Children are less likely to exhibit obvious symptoms of the disease, which restricts the view of the transmission chain between kids. Back on January 23, 2020, the basic reproduction number of SARS-CoV-2 was determined lower than most infectious diseases. According to Statista, COVID-19 could infect up to 2.5 individuals, lower than measles with up to 18 and influenza with up to 3. Effective contact tracing of students who have been infected with COVID-19 is one way to control new clusters.